it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here, it makes me wanna...
Hi, loves. Looking past the mirror. Don't stress through the night at a time, and my life ain't worried about if you feel it. Got my head on straight, I got my vibe right. I ain't gonna let you kill it. See, I won't change my life. Hey loves, hey loves, hey loves. Come on in here. As you come in, tap the screen. Let me know where you're chiming in from. Peace, 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 loves. Come on in here. Looking past the mirror.
Ain't worried about you and what you're gonna do. I'm a lady, so I must stay classy. Gotta keep it high, keep it together. If I want to get better, see, I won't change.
Maryland. Hey, Jamie. Maryland, how are you, love? Hello, Justin. Hey, 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 peace from Tennessee. Yes, Davna, peace from Tennessee. Hey, Levy, how are you, love? Hello, loves. Thank you for the follow, Midnight Girl. Come on in here. Before we get started, we always vibe. Come on now. Let's get these energies flowing. Let's get this good energy flowing. Peace, peace, peace. Come on, tap the screen, share the live. We're about to talk about relationships. Yes, that's my jam too. Mwah. Thank you for the gifts, love. Looking. Come on now. What y'all know about that? Hey, come on. Come on. Get into this good positive energy. Hello. Hi, loves. Peace. Hey, 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 how y'all doing? How are y'all doing this evening? Hello, how are y'all lovelies doing on this beautiful Wednesday? How y'all doing? I'm not sure if you guys read the title. We are discussing relationships. As you came in, you should have seen in there. I'm glad you're good. Hi, Demi Jewel. Hi, love. Hi, beautiful. How are you doing, love? It's good to see you. Hey, Clyde. Levy boy 82. How you doing, love? It's good to see you again. I'm glad that you all are having a wonderful evening. As you come in, help me to share the live. Help me to, you know, tap them hearts, you know, increase the, oh, thank you so much. Listen, 80% of the time I'm happy. 80% of the time I'm on high vibrations. Because if you knew what I knew, yes, life is beautiful. And this frequency is perhaps one of the most profound ways to attract what you want. And speaking about attracting, this evening we are going to be discussing relationships. Hi, Mima. How are you, love? And the question, the question of the evening is, are you ready? Are you ready for love? Are you open to receiving love, to giving love? For those of you who do not know me, and this is your first time with me on this side of the TikTok, you are being introduced to none other than your favorite self-mastery and relationship solutionist. I teach all things self-mastery mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially, so you can get into the frequency alignment, so you can attract the who you want, the who's you want in your life, the wonderful opportunities, the networks, so you can attract whatever you want, and so you can start doing it now. And I realized that statistics, even though I don't subscribe to these statistics so often, statistics show that there are far too many of us that are spending these holidays alone and single, right? And even though I don't celebrate most of these holidays, I do want to inform you, give you the necessary information, the necessary knowledge, the necessary resources, so you can have what you need. So the next season that comes around, you will not be one of the individuals, the men or women who is single for the holidays without a partner. I don't know about you, but there's many of us who are not in beautiful, profound, healthy, wholesome relationships, which I know that a lot of the conversations that we are having as far as what he's doing, what she's doing, what she's not doing, what he's not doing, the unaccountability issues, the irresponsible issues, all of these different dynamics and discussions that we are having because we are not in healthy, wholesome relationships, which lead me to know, not only gather the information that I've gathered from coaching the thousands of men and women that I have coached and are coaching right now. It's not that many, but right now in the seasons that I'm coaching, one of the main reasons why we are not engaging, entertaining, or getting into healthy relationships is because we are not as prepared as we think we are. And this is the discussion this evening. I don't celebrate the holidays every day. Love matters most. Ashe, I agree. I don't celebrate these holidays either. However, I do know that whether you're celebrating a holiday, whether you are just celebrating life, right? Whether you are just navigating through life, breezing through life, existing, thriving through life, we all need someone. We are deserving to have that man or that woman in our life who we can enjoy life with. Thou significant other, our confidant, our friend, our business partner, if that's the goal, our intimate partner, right? Realize that there are some magical things that can happen when you're in a relationship, a healthy, wholesome relationship. There are doors that will only be open when he or she enters your life. There will be locks that will only be unlocked when the two keys are ignited as one. Peace, Queen. How are you, love? Right? And so, since I am solutions-based, I want to give some healthy reasons as to why most of us should retract and do the necessary work. Because what we've been doing up until now isn't working. Repeating the same behavior patterns isn't working. As far as choosing a mate, as far as the way we choose men and women to date, It isn't working because we're finding ourselves in the same toxic relationships that we don't want to get in. And so that lets me know that there is a major issue with selection, how we're selecting the men or women to entertain, to allow them in our world and for making the decision for us to enter into their world. And this has got to change. In order for you to recreate your reality, recreate the dynamics, to change, to make better, more informative, more wise decisions when dealing with relationships, when choosing, you have to do the necessary work. Because I don't know whether it's a holiday or not, no one in their right mind, no man or woman in their right mind are willingly, with wisdom, with all the information and knowledge that is out here as to the benefits of having a profound, significant other that is also operated in wholesome, wouldn't desire that. Many of us are going home crying, sleeping, we're miserable, we're unheard. We feel like we're unseen. We feel like we're invisible. We feel like we are undeserving. We feel like we are not worthy. We feel like no one out in the world is like us or experiencing certain things that we're experiencing. And far too many of us are have been single for way too long. Realize that it's a difference from spending time, taking time to yourself to work on yourself and taking time not working on yourself. However, still choosing to engage, still choosing to get into situationships, and it's not healthy. It is one of the most destructive things to get into relationships or situationships or engage in a man or woman on an intimate basis with the intent to date them, with the intent to marry them, to have a future with them. If you don't understand foundational principles and actually apply the work that you learn, not doing so keeps us on a perpetual cycle of making informative, destructive decisions. And I don't know about you, but I know many of us out there are really sick and tired of finding ourselves alone throughout the days, throughout the weeks, throughout the months, throughout the years, throughout the holidays, if you celebrate them, right? It is not a flex saying that, oh, I've been single for 5, 6, 7, 10, 20 years. I've been celibate for 5, 6, 7, 20 plus years. It does not require that extensive amount of time to prepare yourself for love if you actually knew the benefits is in it. If you actually realize all of the wonderful opportunities you can have by being in a beautiful relationship. Now, when I say beautiful relationship, I'm not talking about 100% of the time you're going to be all glowing and happy and you're going to like the individual. I'm not speaking of that. I'm speaking of relationships in regard to a wise manner, with a wise and intellectual, coherent, comprehensive concept of being engaged in a relationship. Because when one is wholesome mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially, that's what one is going to attract. And the fact that many women and men alike are not attracting other men and women who are also wholesome and healthy says that there's some work that we need to be doing, right? Because results don't lie. Results do not lie. Receipts do not lie. And so that there's something missing, right? And I want to help us figure out what's missing. What's the missing link? A lot of us are making poor decisions because we are acting in a place of disparity, desperateness. Ashe, Diva 9. We're making decisions with a desperate vibration. And whenever you're making decisions out of desperateness, you make poor decisions, right? Let's give the example. let's talk about a woman. I'm just going to, you know, just visualize a woman, right? And we all have been there. I'll use myself. Disregard that. I'm not even going to make up a fictitious woman. I'm going to use myself as an example. When I wasn't where I was supposed to be, when I wasn't where I needed to be, in the level in which I needed to be, when I was dating, right? Before I gained this information, when I didn't have the mental, spiritual, emotional, physical, and financial means to be okay, more than okay, for whatever season I was in, I made poor choices in choosing the men. So instead of me choosing a man with wise standards, with core values that were beneficial, I was making decisions based upon what that man can do for me, not what we can do for each other, not what I can do for him, how I can amplify him with just being in my divine femininity, right? I was making poor decisions because, for one, at that point where I wasn't financially stable. So for me, choosing a mate to be in my life, the number one thing that was on my priority list was this man have to make enough money so he can take care of me and provide for me. Not in a sense that naturally men are supposed to be the protectors, the providers, you know, the provisionaries. However, because I was in a financial state of lack, that was my number one priority, that this man had to make enough money for me. And you know what that did? That made me less accountable for my own financial situation. None of us should be choosing from a place of lack, because that's what you're going to get, lack. None of us should be choosing based upon when we feel desperate for something, or being needy of something. Very different from needing, because we need each other, but being needy of something. I was needy of a man having money because I wasn't financially stable to a degree where that wasn't the first priority on my list, even though it was important. And that is the wrong mentality to go into a relationship with. That is the wrong, that is an unhealthy, unwise criteria and a demand for me to have put on another man. It wasn't supposed to be that way. And so many of us are operating in desperateness. Many of us are choosing based on loneliness. Many of us are choosing men and women based upon lack. If you lack in wisdom, you're going to be needy of someone having more wisdom than you to guide you. You're always going to be operating from a codependent state instead of an independent state. What you can do together versus what that person can only do for you. And that's not a healthy way of doing things. Because the results that I thought I was going to get, and having that being my number one criteria, that man had to have money, was the absolute unhealthy, unbeneficial way of me choosing. Right? Even though that's a huge standard and a criteria that we both should have, men and women. Not that so much a number being placed on it, right? It's not that I need that man to make six figures, seven figures, right? However, that man and that woman has to be financially stable enough and have the financial ambition enough so we can grow. But my decision should not only be predicated upon what that man has, because that's an area in which I lack. That's not healthy for us to do. And it's a huge reason why many of us should pull back and wait before you start dating. And if you already are dating, perhaps you should reconsider if you're not getting the results that you think you should be getting. Ashe, peace, purpose, how are you? I will never love that. Not an amount. It's not so much about amount, because there's men and women out here making all types of money in different brackets, and they are still wholesome individuals ready to love you, honor you, cherish you, protect you, provide for you, depending on the life that you're living. All women ain't out here talking about, I want a high value man. And that being connected to you being a high earning man. High value, high worth does not equal high value. It doesn't have a number to it. And a wise woman and a wise man knows that. Now, I'm not saying there's anything unright about wanting a person that is a high figure earner. But let's be honest. Many of us who are making these type of demands and requests from men or women aren't in the very same position. You aren't mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually, or financially qualified to request any of those things that most of us are requesting in today's time. It is absolutely foolish to hear some women talking about, I want a seven-figure man, or a man talking about, I want a seven-figure woman. A high earning man or woman, when you only make $15,000, $16,000, $17,000, $20,000 a year. How do you figure that even equates to you being qualified for that to be a criteria in a demand in a request for you? It does not. It's not just about being realistic. It's about being wise, because money is energy and it can be obtained at the snap of a finger. If you knew what you knew, if you had the necessary information, especially if those of you who have enrolled in my classes, I teach you how to get into energetic alignment to attract certain things. So money should not be an issue to a wise man or woman, because they know that money is only energy and that it can be obtained. You can attract money on demand. If you simply did what was required to energetically put yourself in alignment. And so the longer you keep choosing not to elevate mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, financially, the longer it's going to take for you to actually attract that man or that woman that you are supposed to be with within your season. The duration of that season is very different. That's a whole nother masterclass, because situations, people, places, and things are purposed to come to a completion. Now, that completion can mean when a soul transitions back home, or the completion could mean that you and him or him and her have served their purpose, and now it's come to a completion, and now it's time to separate, to embrace what you're supposed to be embracing for your new levels. Your perspectives shape your reality. And when you're not informative, and when you do not have the necessary resources and are applying those resources in which, excuse me, I call self-mastery, you will never live up to your highest potential, and you will keep making unwise decisions, not only in regards to relationships, be it platonic or intimate, but any decision that you make in your life. And isn't it time for us to get off the hamster wheel? Don't you want to get off that hamster wheel going nowhere? Many of us aren't aware that we're running on this hamster wheel we call in progress, going nowhere fast. And ever so often, you actually realize that you are in the very same place, space, and situation that you was in years ago. So the question is, when are you going to choose to get off the hamster wheel and actually do something about it? The time is now. For many of you, y'all going to be celebrating New Year's in a couple of weeks. For many of us, the new sun cycle is approaching. Why would anyone in their right mind choose to keep doing the same damn things, repeating the same unhealthy generational behavior patterns Why would anyone in their right mind choose to do that? Yet when someone says that you're acting like you're insane, it's all of a sudden now, oh, you disrespecting me. You're digging me. You're stabbing. It's not that. However, unless we're transparently honest with ourselves, things will not change. As a self-mastery coach and relationship solutionist, it is not my business to tell you only what you want to hear. In truth, it is my responsibility to tell you what you need to hear. It's up to you to do with it as you wish. However, if you receive it, I guarantee you it will change the dynamics of your whole entire life and the lives of your family. However, we have to stop skipping steps. We have to stop being so easily led astray with every fake ass, excuse my French, because I don't apologize for that. For every person that comes before you telling you how to get rich quick next week, how to attract a man or a woman next week without you actually doing the work. It doesn't work that way. You have to be transparently honest with yourself. It does not work that way. You are only going to get according to what you invest in. Understand that when you invest monetary things, that's what you're going to get. And you're not going to be able to keep it because you have yet to learn what it takes to cultivate the things in which you're going to attract. So not only do I teach you how to get an energetic alignment to attract, I teach you how to cultivate whatever it is when you do attract. Otherwise, what's the point? Let me know who in their right mind will willingly put money in a bag if it has a hole in it and keep on walking and just keep on putting your coins in there and they keep on falling out. And you actually look at the bag and realize it has a hole in it. You say, oh, well, you just keep on putting money in there. No wise man or woman chooses to do such foolish things. So why are we willingly choosing to skip steps when we are so much more important and valuable and deserve so much more? The main reason is because many of us don't think we are as valuable or as worthy as we think we are, or as wise or as healed as we think we are. Because if we were, there would be less foolish, stupid conversations that are being had about 50-50. That is the most disgraceful conversations and despicable, stupid, idiotic, toxic ass conversations that men or women that we are having with one another today. As far as, does 50-50 work for you? Does it work? What's your thoughts on it? Like, what are we entertaining? Yet we're claiming to be healed. We're claiming to be wise. We're claiming to have it together. We're claiming to be healthy. We're claiming to know certain things, yet we're engaging in some of the most foolish energy around us. And your rhyme, reason, justifications, and excuses only make you look that much more crazy. It's absolutely crazy. Or the other huge controversial topic, what are you bringing to the table? I mean, have anyone ever sat down and asked yourself really, like, how foolish is that? What are you bringing to the damn table? As if that's not an extreme metaphor. What are you bringing to the table? And us men and women are actually engaging in these conversations talking about, well, I can cook and I can clean and I'm smart and I can have sex and I know how to, you know, lick good, and my sex is the bomb, and I'm smart, and I have this amount of degrees, and I have this amount of money, and I have all of these things. Is that what you really bring to the table? Really? Is that all you are worth? Your triceps, your biceps, your sex game, your tongue game, your money, your gifts and your skills? Is that all you're worth? Seriously. And we're coming in droves to entertain these foolish conversations. It's crazy. I never asked a woman these questions. Purpose? Because you know better. It's absolutely foolish. Riri, yes, it's so true. It is absolutely foolish. Truth, beloved. Absolutely. Thank you so much for the compliment, love. I'm reading some of y'all comments. This woman makes me want to jump through the phone. Ashe, it's crazy. The time is now. I want you to realize. I want you to elevate. You are worth so much more. Divine man and woman. You are worth so much more than what you think you are. And you can actually demand everything that you want, need, and desire. The time is now. Ashe, feminine energy. The time is now. Know your self-worth. And that sounds like a cliche, know your self-worth. However, because of the years of coaching, the 20 plus years, many of us simply do not really understand what divine worth is. Because a man or woman who knows, like truly understands their worth, would not be easily swayed by other men and women who is operating opposite of that. Wise, intellectual, discerning men or women who truly know their worth and how invaluable they are and what they actually bring according to just who they are, divine masculine and divine feminine, do not entertain men or women who is beneath them intellectually. And that's not being disrespectful. That's just saying until once you get to a point where you're more aware of who you are in your divinity, you don't even entertain men or women that's coming with the foolishness. You don't even, first of all, we very seldomly attract men if you're a woman and woman if you're a man, vice versa. We very seldomly attract men or women who are in the lower nature, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially. I don't even attract them type of men no more. I have actually, even in my ignorant days, in my unlearned days, I've never ever had a man ask me, what do you bring to the table? What can you offer? You want to know why? And something that I've heard plenty of times from men, why they were so attracted to me? Because before I even realized it, I was operating in my femininity. My energy alone captivated them, intoxicated them. It kept drawing them to me. It wasn't what I was doing. It was what I was being. And I didn't even realize it to the capacity then. Then I realize it now. And so when I tell you it's time to elevate, I only give 5 minutes. I keep telling you purpose, you gracious, baby, because you don't even get five, honey. You don't get 5 minutes with me. When you have learned the things that you need to learn to elevate, when you have actually made the necessary sacrifices to elevate, when you know the dangers of just entertaining other energies that can affect you in either a negative way or positive way, or should I say an extremely healthy way or an extremely unhealthy way, you do not even give individuals 2 minutes, because within the first minute, you have gained enough discernment and intuition not to play with your life like that. It comes down to that. And the biggest reasons why we do is because we don't understand energy and aura. Simply standing next to someone, simply being on this live, you and me, everyone who is here right now, simply engaging energetically like this, we are influencing one another. And if you have not yet learned how to protect your energy and your aura, It can affect you in the most unhealthy ways. This is why many of us be asking ourselves these questions. Why all of a sudden do I feel like this? You can be so happy, vibing high, and all of a sudden you feel miserable, or you feel a sadness, or you all of a sudden feel a deep loneliness, whatever it may be. If you are not in practice of self-mastery, or not in practice of being aware of your energy and cultivating your energy, it will affect you in ways in which can be completely destructive for you. And we have to understand, it's like we have to stop playing with ourselves. So when we're speaking about relationships, yes, indeed, you are supposed to wait until you get yourself together as much as you need to. And don't misunderstand me. I don't want you to misunderstand me. You are never going to be completely healed. Let's be clear, and please stop speaking to these uninformed, misguided men and women out here telling you otherwise. You will never be completely healed before you allow yourself to be loved and allow yourself to love wholly, whole in a wholesome way. Because some of your healing is going to come when that man or that woman enters your life. Certain levels you're not going to get to until that man or woman enters your life. It is one of the divine purposes of uniting with the opposite polarities. If you are divine feminine, that means divine masculine. If you are divine masculine, that means divine feminine. So the idea that you are holding back, with one of the reasons being that you are not completely healed, you are completely missing your healing. Wink, wink. Are y'all getting what I'm throwing? Are y'all getting what I'm throwing? It's imperative that you realize that. Ashe, you do not have to be completely healed. You just have to be healed enough so you can be able to navigate through the dating and courting process with patience, with wisdom, with guidance, without being desperate and without being in lack. You just need to have enough energy, fortitude, and information and vibration mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially so that you can sustain the process. Because when you are practicing self-mastery, when you've elevated to certain levels, and remember, there are levels within levels, there are cycles within cycles, just as the seasons will continually, infinitely move in and out through each other, in through and out of each other, so will you. And so the purpose of you learning the art of self-mastery, how will you know if you've elevated or if you've grown? Thank you so much for the gift, love. How would you know if you never experience, or if you disregard or run from the experience the universe are giving you to apply what you've learned? And many of us are reading the books, we're taking the courses, we're doing what we have to do, we're practicing, we're doing everything, we're putting ourselves in positions, yet you run away from the very experience that's going to allow you to apply everything that you learn. That's crazy. That's one of the things that Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy is going to be teaching. And even though it's exclusively for women, I do have other courses and other classes that I offer both men and women. No, I am not married, love. Not yet. Understand that when you learn something, you have to allow the universal experience for you to apply what you've learned. Realize that the infinite source of creation, whatever you call God, your ancestors, the universe, will always give you experiences so you can apply what you learned. That is going to be the ultimate determination whether you succeed. or whether you still need some work. The experience is going to teach you whether you can actually move forward or whether you should retract a little bit so you can work some things out. And many of us are afraid to endure the experience. Now, I'm not talking about just jump into any type of create an experience, just engage in any old experience. I'm not speaking about that. I'm speaking about when you are actually one who has done the work or is doing the work. And now, according to the level and the investment of the work that you're doing, the universe is going to send you a man or woman in which you can apply what you learned. That man or woman may be the man or woman that you need to be for seasons and not a season. Or if they're supposed to be there just for the lesson. But too many of us are getting wrapped up in a seasonal person that only came into our life to give us the necessary experience it takes so we would know if we actually are ready, prepared. Right? Y'all understand what I'm dropping? Let me know if you understand what I'm dropping so I can pause for a minute. Would a same gender loving woman benefit from your VIP class? Absolutely. Here's the thing. I stand for righteousness. That's it. I stand for divine love. As a self-mastery coach, as a self-mastery solutionist and relationship solutionist, I am not biased of how you love, who you love, not how, I teach you how, most in effective ways, but who you love. You love who you love. I'm here to give you the tips, the information, because I am not an owner. I'm not the owner of your soul. I'm not the owner of your path. And so if that's your path, that's your path. I don't have biases. I am unbiased and unjudgmental. You want to love a man, you want to love a woman. If you're the same sex, that has nothing to do with me. As long as people are not forcing their narratives on me, we good. However, my teachings are for everyone. As long as that individual that I'm coaching has the intent to use it for wisdom and not destruction. It's simple for me. So absolutely, it works for all women. They, no matter what they choose in their personal life. But do y'all understand? I'm not biased of nobody's path. I don't hold those type of, I have my own ideologies, my own opinions, my own knowings, my own beliefs. I have my own things. I know what I like, what I don't like. My professional work is completely separate from my personal work. I've been doing this for 20 plus years. I do not entangle the two. I do not entangle the two. I'm a complete professional. Okay. I don't hold biases. Love is love. It doesn't matter who you are or what you choose. Love is love. Now, toxic love, I don't know about that. I ain't got too much time to be dealing with folk that, that just want to be toxic. So yes, it will benefit. So don't be stingy. Don't be greedy. Don't be trying to harbor. You know, don't be trying to hoard. Let your aunties know. Let your sisters know. Let your daughters know. Yes, Reese, you have to be willing to be taught. Let your cousins know, your female cousins. Let them know that Rise of a Goddess Academy is exclusively for the divine feminine. And is exclusively for sisterhood, right? Because there's too many dysfunctional narratives going around where sisters can't support sisters, where women can't genuinely support sisters, where we can't respectfully, with empathy and righteously hold each other accountable for operating and elevating within our higher selves. This is a profound sisterhood, and anyone who is on this live who knows me, who have registered and have invested in any one of my courses, my classes, my boot camps, my mini courses, any of those things, know that it is a complete safe space that I create for divine women. I do not tolerate riffraff, disrespect. I don't tolerate none of that because you can get gone real quick. So anyone, excuse me, who knows me know that I create and generate a safe place. Okay, so let's get back into relationships. Being thirsty and desperate enables you and just encourages you to keep making foolish decisions when choosing mates. And I will say time and time again, whether you know it or not, whether you understand it or not, whether you believe it or not, whether you subscribe to it or not, the universe operates on frequency. The universe responds to frequency. You do not get what you want. You get according to what you are. And when I mean by you get what you are, according to the frequencies that you're vibrating on, that's how the universe, that's how the universe responds to you. So if you're one, and I tell you all the time, pay attention to the words that you're using, because most of us are cursing our lives and ourselves every day. Not only are you telling the infinite genie that is there to give you whatever you wish for, you're also telling trillions of souls, the 75 trillions of souls that are conscious, to do exactly what you're speaking. So if you're a person that is in the knowing or unknowing in your verbal communication, thank you so much for the gifts, love, Rashad. I think that's your name, Rashad. If you are a person that is unaware or even aware of how they're speaking, most of us who speak don't even understand the power and what we're doing to ourselves. So if you are a person that's constantly saying to yourself, oh, I'm broke, guess what the universe gonna give you? Experiences that is gonna keep you broke. If you are a man or woman who is constantly saying, oh, I'm ugly, or I'm just not deserving, even if that's the energy you're putting out. So sometimes you don't need to verbally say it, because your thoughts are signals. They are also frequency. And this is why mental mastery is important. This is why I teach the 5 pillars of self-mastery: mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially. Because until you actually learn what they are and how they impact and create your reality, your reality is going to remain the same. So let's get back to it. Even if you don't verbally speak these things, your thought speaks for you as well. And when your verbal words and your thoughts is not in alignment, or whatever they're in alignment with, that's what you're going to get. So if you're a person that's constantly saying, oh, I can't do this, guess what? The universe is going to keep on giving you experience that's going to prove that you can't do. If you're a person that is constantly vibrating with loneliness, guess what? The universe is going to constantly bring you people that's going to come into your life and walk right back out of your life after they done toyed with your emotions. If you're a person that displays envy and jealousy, guess what? That's what you're going to get. You get what you give. It's like the banking, it's like the business system and concept, return on investment. You are only going to get according to what you invest in, whether you know it or not. This is why awareness is so important. And this is one of the reasons, since we're talking about relationships, of why you keep choosing the same unhealthy, dysfunctional, toxic men or women in your life, because you're not aware of the why you're doing what you're doing. And until you realize and are aware of the why you keep doing what you're doing year after year, there is nothing that's going to change, my loves. And I know many of us desire for change. I am convinced many of us are desiring change, because many of us are on the brink of jumping off that cliff. Many of us are at our breaking points. Many of us are imploding, exploding from inside out, because the pressure is getting so heavy. However, even though I have compassion and empathy for seeing the men or women that are broke, broken, bruised, lonely, and experiencing the seemingly hell that they're going through, I have no sympathy, because you have a choice. And when you're constantly choosing to keep skipping steps in your elevation, you're going to constantly get the same results. You're not powerless. So this is why I don't coddle. This is why I don't condone. This is why I don't join a pity party. This is why if my approach is the way it is. I'm not here to tell you what you want to hear. I'm here to tell you what you need to hear. And I don't need to hear the whole past story. I need just the facts. Just give me the facts and the logistics. Because my concern is the solution, helping you rediscover the solution. Help you to remember that you are the solution, that you're not powerless, you're powerful. You're not inferior, you are superior. Everything about you is powerful, especially if you are a melanated, carbonated black man or woman. No disrespect to no one else. Especially, you are one of the most powerful and resourceful, phenomenal creations that have ever been created on this planet, in this realm. And so the fact that many of us are acting outside of that, I'm not here to stroke your back. I don't even have a kitty cat to stroke. I'm damn sure not stroking your back. I'm going to tell you what you need to hear, and hopefully it registers enough to get you up off your ass and to realize who you are. To realize that you have the power to manifest and create. But if you keep every moment that you get, every moment that you receive this beautiful breath of life to be here, every moment you get to choose to do better, when you know damn well you could be doing better, when you realize that what you've been doing ain't working, every moment of that beautiful breath that you take and you keep choosing not to get the help that you need and you're not activated, actively practicing in that, I don't feel sorry for you. I can want the very best for you, the greatest for you. Like many of us do. However, we cannot force your will. It's against galactic principle. Those who know what I just said know. It's against galactic universal laws to violate another person's will. This is why in the movies that you see, any type of wicked thing that ever happens or that try to enters, you need to give permission. You need to give access. You need to grant access. And many of you in your unlearned thoughts, in your unlearned behaviors, willingly give these entities, other people, places, and things permission to run your life. To create your narratives, to create your perspectives. And until you stand up and retract and take back your power, until you break the agreements that you made. And some of these things that I'm speaking to you about is within my 5-day mini masterclass. 5-day self-love challenge. We go into depth about these things, how to break the agreement. Because until you break the agreement, the program, you're going to continually do what you've been doing. Even if you take 2 steps forward, you're going to end up taking 5 steps back because you don't know how to cultivate it. And that dominant program will always win. What you feed will continually gain power, and what you starve will continually lose power. Whether you know it or not, you're feeding the very thing that you're running from that you don't want anymore. And that can be anything. So a lot of these things that I'm teaching you in this synopsis, in this short version, I go into depth about within the 5-day self-love challenge. If you're interested, click the link in my bio and go register. And let me come back and let me know if you have any questions that I can answer. It also helps you get into alignment when we're speaking about relationships. You don't know as much as you need to know before you enter into a relationship. You don't, and that's evident. That is extremely evident according to the results that we're getting. Many of us are just haphazardly jumping into these situations, not knowing what we actually need to know from these individuals. Understand that. And we're so desperate. And I know that sounds really harsh. However, it's true. It is what it is. Even that's the word that I choose to use. However, it really is what it is. Many of us are choosing because we're desperate. We don't even care to vet these men and women wisely. We don't really care about their personality traits, their characteristic traits. We don't care to learn about their behavior patterns. We don't care to learn about their morals and their values because we're so swept away by the sweet little things they telling us in our ear. You're beautiful. You're so loving. You're so smart. You're so wise. Oh my goodness, you got a lot going on. And I love the way you do this. And I love the way you do that. And you know, they take you on a couple of dates. And the next thing you know, you planning your whole damn wedding around what? Knowing nothing, absolutely nothing, having no discipline, not knowing that you're worth so much more. Stop giving your most invaluable energy, your most invaluable precious yonis and phalluses to men or women who has yet to prove themselves to be deserving of it, to have proven themselves that they can also honor you the way you honor you. Protect you like you protect you. Cultivate you like you cultivate you. Respect you how you respect you. Cherish you how you cherish you. Provide for you how you provide for you. Love on you. Understand that. And then next thing you know, we giving them and granting them access to all of us. And they haven't even proven themselves. Some of y'all don't even know that man or woman's middle name or their mama and daddy name before they up in your house and in your bed. And then you wondering why the next week or the next month you experiencing emotional turmoil. You wondering why things are just going crazy in your life. You wondering why now you're not feeling in harmony with yourself, in tune with yourself. Why things are just not unorganized within you, externally and internally. We have to stop that. And I understand that sometimes we just don't know what we don't know, and that's okay. However, realize until you realize you don't know what you don't know and get the help that you need, you're going to continually be completely disappointed. And you may find yourself imploding from the inside and on the same bridge that we see other men and women on because, and I say this with the most compassion, and sincerity, hear me when I say this. If you find yourself on that bridge, ready to jump, ready to give up, and that's metaphorically, I'm not speaking physically, I'm speaking metaphorically. Realize that you played a big part in how you got there. Realize that no one can force you to say who, when, what, why, how, when, not how, but when, who, when, what, why, when. No one can force that. Many of us are metaphorically on that bridge because we willingly are not doing what we need to do to heal enough to be able to sustain, to be able to cultivate relationships in any capacity, intimately, platonically, business-wise, friendships, whatever it means. There's so many variables and concepts of ships in regard to relationships. Realize that many of us who are on them bridges have played a huge part in being there. And that's the undesirable truth. That's not an opinion. It's not a philosophy. It's not a fact. I mean, it's not a fact depending on who it's coming from. It's an undesirable truth. And until you begin to take accountability and responsibility for your self-development, for you raising your levels of awareness, self-love, self-concept, and self-actualization, until you begin to raise your level of perceptions and perspectives, things are only going to stay the same. Are y'all getting what I'm putting down? Make sure you guys are tapping the screen, share the lives, because this information can help save someone. Thank you so much for the follow. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate you. I sincerely appreciate you. So let's check my notes. Many of these, we're not giving men and women enough time. Since we're speaking about relationships, for those of you who are just joining me, my name is Venus, a goddess. I am a self-mastery and relationship solutionist. Blah. I am a self-mastery and relationship solutionist. I teach all things self-mastery mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially. Why? Because the five pillars of self-mastery is at the core of everything you've done, everything you're doing, and everything that you want to do. And because most of us are not completely satisfied, happy, or receiving the abundance we should in our current reality, I teach how to recreate your reality by teaching self-mastery. So if you are loving what I'm putting down, if you're appreciative of the information, you know, do me an honor of, you know, helping me to share the message by sharing. If you're led to, no pressure. Also by tapping the screen. I appreciate the taps. I appreciate the love. I appreciate the gifts. I appreciate those of you who have became a subscriber to show your appreciation for me coming here before you and teaching what I teach. For anyone who is interested in any of the teaching lives that I often go live and I teach on a various amount of subjects, everything regarding all things self-mastery, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's completely free. There I post all of my previous lives here. You can never have too many tools in your toolbox when it comes to navigating in through in this beautiful thing called life. Right? You can never have too many tools. So if you missed anything or just want some helpful information, there are tons of videos on there where I'm teaching on various amounts of topics, right? So many of us are getting into these relationships and we're not even vetting. Thank you so much for the gifts, love. Cordell, thank you so much for the gifts, love. Many of us are not vetting with wisdom. And I actually am creating how to vet with wisdom when you're getting into relationships, right? Even if you're currently in a relationship, you still can learn to vet if you have not reached a certain season and time and space within your current relationship, even if it has been long term. Certain things like that I am going to be teaching within the Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy also, right? Many of us are not vetting properly because oftentimes the men and women who we are attracting, right, are just as hurt if you are still hurting, just as broken if you are in a broken state or a lonely state or any state of lack, right? You're attracting these men or women and you're not even doing the work for yourself, let alone giving them an opportunity to show you who they really are. Because we're so easily swayed by the way they look and the way they're presenting themselves. And I'm not saying that men or women present when we put our best foot forward. They represent their representative, right? Many of us, for me, my perspective is that it's okay to present yourself in whatever capacity you present yourself. Because I'm a firm knower and we are who we are when we need to be them. So if you have a child, if you need to be the doctor at the moment, you're going to be a doctor. So the way you present yourself is going to be within that energy, right? And so depending on the type of atmosphere, especially if you are a divine feminine, right? If we were to enter an atmosphere or say a place of business or whatever, and we feel threatened in any type of way, or if we feel unsafe, we're going to operate in our masculine, right? Because it's the masculine energy that protects and the feminine energy that nurtures. So depending on the area, the element, the environment, the space, the situation, you are going to be whoever you need to be. However, whoever the representation is displaying, that is also a part of that individual. Like, and we have to stop thinking that we're going to get the whole totality of a person within the first date or the first few dates. It's not how that works. You don't get to have access to my bathroom after the first date. You don't get to see me in my raw, comfortable, safe place after a first few dates, especially if I don't even care to know your middle name yet. You don't get to see that. Prime example. Lord have mercy. We are funny sometimes. So I remember a guy that I was about to date. We communicating on the phone, and within the second conversation, where it was only first, the second conversation, this man asked me, can I send him a picture right then and right now? That could have went several ways. That could have went several ways. However, I brought that up, right, to give an analogy, like, we have to stop expecting for men and women who we are just meeting to show and give everything, every part of them within that first moment. Within those first moments, within those first few dates. It's called dating because we're collecting data, but be wise and know which data is supposed to be collected. Understand? But only wise people can understand this. You don't get to, and for me, that was violating my personal safe place. You don't qualify yet to see me in my raw form. And it has nothing to do with me being ashamed of it. Absolutely nothing. Because without the hair, without the wig, whatever I'm wearing, many of you have seen my natural hair. Many of you. I've came on live transparent many of times. I am who I am. Whether I'm embellished or whether I am in the raw form, I am who I am. My appearance doesn't change drastically just because I have earrings on. Thank you so much for the gift, Cordell. Doesn't change just because I have eyelashes on. It doesn't change because I have gloss on my lips. And what many of us, what I've learned is that I get a lot of compliments when I'm fixed up. And I'm not even like fixed up. I get way more compliments in my raw form. If I was just to run outside, now granted, I'm always clean, cute, and smelling good, right? She steps out. It don't matter. I just said, she steps out. However, you don't get that type of access to me. And we didn't even have the second conversation yet. It was a text that he gave me. So that realize that we tell a lot of our unlearned mentality. We show people a lot. And if you are unlearned, this is why I'm saying many of us don't need to be dating, because you don't know the first thing about how to date wisely, because you're going about it all wrong. And I asked the question, I'm like, you know what? Because I wanted to know, even though I had an idea, I wanted to know, because, you know, most times now I went into the coaching mode, because he completely done fell off the perspective of him being a perspective. Like, I already shut that door. The moment he sent that text, the door was already shut. So now I'm going into, okay, let me help this brother out. So hopefully he understand what transpires next, so he can move into the next, you know, woman with wisdom. And I asked him, I said, what made you ask me that question, right? He proceeds to text me again, dating wisely, Ashe. Ashe, Divine Feminine Energy, he proceeds to still text instead of call, because we know that text messages oftentimes are misunderstood because you're not verbally having that conversation. However, I engage because I'm also a researcher. This is how I create content that better serves who I'm serving, because it's coming directly from you. The issues are coming directly from you, just like the issues came directly from me when it was time for me to be aware of what I needed to correct. So in his unlearned behavior, he sends a text and I'm like, well, what possessed you to ask me this question? You know, what in your mind provoked you to encourage you to ask me this question? Oh, because, and it was, I met him through an online date. You know, that so it needed time and he didn't want to simmer, honey. So he proceeds to say that he's been, I guess, bamboozled before, or oftentimes when he's speaking to a woman, they don't necessarily match their pictures. They look completely different or off. And he went, and I said, here's number one, your first mistake that excluded you from your last message. And this is what I mean by most of us are not prepared as we think we are. It is absolutely unwise, unintelligent to assume that the next woman you meet is going to do as past women you meet. Whenever you bring your past into your now, it predicts your future, and your future becomes your past. You should never, never assume that what you've been through according to someone else is the same thing you're going to go through with that new person. Your present way of doing things should not be predicated on your past, and it sure as hell shouldn't be enforced on the person that you want now. And so not only was the question just classless, right, and disqualified him off the jump because he judged me based upon his past experiences, right? I am not them women, honey. And even, I'm not saying that his thought process, there was nothing unrighteous. I don't like saying wrong or right because I don't subscribe to that. However, I'll use that. There was nothing wrong about his question, right? Nothing wrong about his question. The only thing is that he allowed his question to dictate his present, because his question was predicated on a past experience, which was to some degree traumatizing for him, obviously, because he don't know me. He's getting to know me. And for you to presume or assume that I am anything like who you've met, you already done disqualified yourself, honey, already. And that's what I'm speaking about. We are not prepared as we need to be, as we would like ourselves to be, or as we think would be. And this is how, and this is why I want to offer my services, because I know you deserve a profound and divine love. I know you do. And how often are we missing these opportunities because there are not a lot of women like me who is going to take the time and educate you on what you did that's not working. So I use that opportunity to educate him. What he do with it, that's his business. That's completely his business and what he decided to do with it. Hopefully, hopefully he used wisdom and he don't do that again. Right? Because if he would have acted wisely and just waited, he would have seen that them pictures, baby, didn't do any justice. Just like pictures normally don't do any justice. He wasn't wise enough to understand that, you know what? I'm not going to judge this woman's actions based upon what other women have done in my past. I'm actually going to be patient, have meaningful conversations with this woman, and hopefully she agrees to actually meet me when she feels safe enough. And then I can actually see if her face, her pictures match her face when I see her. We don't have to be thirsty or forceful. When you are in alignment, you don't have to force no one to do anything, because everything will always be revealed to you. But when you're acting out of desperate, when you're acting in desperateness, when you're acting desperate, when you're being forceful, when you're being impatient, it never works out for you. I could have been the biggest blessing in that man's life. However, I'm completely unbothered because I know what I know. It's an easy move on for me. I embrace experiences because, just like I mentioned earlier, I apply while what I've learned. I'm still learning. I'm still on my journey. Even though I've been practicing what I teach and teaching for 20 plus years, baby, I still have a whole lot of purpose on this realm. You feel me? Which means I am a student of life. I'm going to keep on learning. And how do I know if I've elevated? By applying it. One thing I used to work on is my patience and my tolerance. Now, that man would have either gotten I would have completely ignored him or gave him a version of me that he probably wouldn't have took too kindly in my unlearned self. However, the approach I took extended from me practicing self-mastery. Even though I knew he was disqualified, I was patient enough and loved him enough because I loved myself enough, because I would have wanted someone to genuinely, respectfully tell me, like, you know what you just did, it isn't healthy and it isn't working. Here's a suggestion moving forward so you can be more successful in your approach. Understand what I'm saying? You need experiences to apply what you've learned. And this is what I teach. Yes, I use it as a teaching moment. And hopefully he got it. No one can be someone else, baby. We are so many individuals. We are multifaceted. We have multi personalities. So the fact that people be calling people bipolar because we are one way in one case and in another way. Thank you so much, love, for your compliment. Right. Understand, you just met me. I'm reading some of the comments. This is for them young, quick ones. This one was in age, and we'll tell. He was of age. This is why I don't subscribe to avatar age, because it has nothing to do with your maturity and your mentality. Right. And it was like absolutely sad. Peace, Eric. How are you? And so I use that as a teachable moment. And this is why we need to learn how to date again. This is the reason why we need to know how to court and wisely. Otherwise, we're going to continually entertain men and women who are going to cause us to be further distracted from the overall goal of experiencing such wholesome love. However, peace, love, thank you so much, Eric. If you are not operating from a place of a self-full love, you will not get it, and you will be unable to give it. And it's unhealthy. Dysfunction breeds dysfunction. Disorder breeds disorder. Confusion breeds confusion. How long are you going to continually jump into these situationships, entertaining men or women, and you're not prepared? And if most of you were really transparently honest with yourself, it is crushing you from the inside out. Because when you are unprepared, when you are jumping from relationship to relationship to relationship, and you have not, one, learned the art of wisely dating and all the different variables and information and levels that come with it, it can cause you further distress, further discomfort, further disappointment. Your mind is going to continually be at a disadvantage. And it's not healthy. And the next thing you know is that those disappointments have compacted. And the pressure gets so deep to now, only thing you're doing is displaying how broke, broken, and bitter and miserable you are, and blaming the man or the woman or the women or the men that you chose to entertain. You chose to entertain them. in your unwise, unlearned self. With your unlearned and unwise self. You willingly chose to entertain them, and then you want to point the finger when you're disappointed. When it didn't work out. When they done left you or ghosted you. Or when they done took your cookies. Or when you have gave them your most precious and valuable energy. Now you broke, broken, bitter, and miserable. And now you just all types of messed up. Looking crazy out here in these streets. Not realizing that you had a big part to play in it. You didn't take time to vet him properly because you don't know what you think you know. You didn't take time to learn his behavior patterns if he's consistent or inconsistent. Because you too busy falling in love with who he think or says he is instead of getting connected in love with who he actually is and are being. On a consistent basis. You too busy. We too busy falling in love and connected in love and falling in lust with a person's potential. Just because somebody could don't mean that they are. Don't mean that they will. And we have to understand that. You have to be patient with yourself enough. Relationships, getting into relationships, vetting wisely. It requires mental, spiritual, emotional, physical, and financial intelligence and discipline. I always say the most sexiest thing that a man possesses, I'm talking about the divine masculine and the divine feminine, is BDE energy. That is one of the most profoundly sexiest thing that a man has is when he has D discipline. When he knows that he can just give it up to any one of his chasers because he know he has a plethora of options. That ain't an issue for him. When he know that he have women just throwing themselves at him and he chooses not to give up his most invaluable, worthy, powerful energy source, his phallus, that is one of the most profoundly sexiest things that a man possesses. And it's the same for a woman. To know that even though you have men chasing you down, throwing themselves at you, vying for your attention, you do not just give them your powerful yoni just because you can. That's discipline. That's discipline. And many of us don't have as much as we think we have, which is why so many of us are deeply disappointed now because you done gave Tom, Dick, and Harry, and Melissa, Tammy, and Tasha your gifts, and they were undeserving. And not only did you do it? Now you unknowingly transmuted your energy. And the STD is the least of your worries when you engage and when you transmute sexual energy. That's another class we go deep into. I'm not doing all of that here. It's another class, another master class. The power of sexual transmutation. It is a thing. Whether you know it or not, it's affecting some of us in the most dangerous ways. Yes, it's the mental. Rashid, it's the mental, it's the emotional, it's a lot. It's a whole lot. We have to be aware. Right? And so you don't care if the man have standards, boundaries, morals, values. They just go right out the window. In dating, you want to have enough experiences with your potential choice to discern who they are. Not who they telling you they are, who they are. This is why no matter how many questions you ask them, you can ask them 1,001 questions and receive beautiful answers. However, until you actually experience them answering that questions via their actions, you still are in the unknown. We have to stop being so easily swayed by shit that sound cute, that sound pretty. Oh, he said he's a loving, he can be a loving husband and he's a provider and protector. And she wants to cater to me and she wants to serve me and be submissive to me. And she can cook and she gonna do this and he gonna do that. And we just like, oh my God, here you go. That's not working. My dad always taught me you become when you lay down with someone. Yeah, I agree. You become what you consume. And there's many a ways to consume something. Many a ways that there's many a things that you will consume with. Social media, the entertainment world, movies, influences. We're influenced by, you know, the people around us. We're influenced and consume our environment. So many things. And it's just not healthy. And yet we keep running to it, which there's a reason. There's a reason why far too many of us run to toxic conversations while we engage in toxic conversations. There's a reason for that. And they will continue until we learn who we are. A mechanic cannot call himself a mechanic, a true mechanic, right? Unless he can take apart a whole car and put it back together. My perspective. A doctor, no matter what field and area of expertise that he's a doctor, or let's say a gynecologist. That doctor can't wisely say that he's a gynecologist, an expert in gynecology, unless he knows every intricate part in detail about a woman's vagina. Everything. A historian cannot effectively be called or hold the title of an expert historian unless he knows not only his history, cultures of history. And so how can you wisely say that you are a god or a goddess or a queen or just a divine feminine or a divine masculine and you know a fraction of who you are, who you truly are? You have no idea because you choose not to learn about how your external and internal works. So you're walking around with this beautiful, wholesome, divine, powerful avatar. And the only thing you're concerned with is when it moves and that it moves. When you get to a point where you want to learn why it moves, what encourages it to move and act, you will reach a higher level of God, goddesship. You want to be called the queen with no queendom. You want to be called a goddess and you're not even operated within that goddesship, that godship. Same thing with men. You want to be called the king with no kingdom, a god with no goddesship. Because we choose every day to be unaccountable, irresponsible, unreliable, and doing what it takes to operate within that and to cultivate that. Like, what are we doing? And we constantly degrading one another, dehumanizing one another, defeminizing one another, emasculating one another, taking digs at one another, stabbing each other, being jealous of one another, envious of one another, hating each other. Instead of what we were divinely created to do, which is infinitely unconditionally, compassionately loving one another, thriving with one another, uniting, unifying. This is why I'm here. This is why I do what I do. And not this is why I'm extremely successful at what I do. This is why I'm extremely successful at what I do. Because I'm not telling you what hasn't worked. And me doing this, operating and is helping thousands of men and women, 20 plus years and still going, still passionate about what I'm doing. I've seen the dynamics of men and women's life, reality change. Thank you, love. That was really sweet of you. Thank you so much, Rashid. Thank you so very much. I appreciate you. I've seen it not only in my own life, but the lives of the men and women I've coached. Just recently, I had someone join the 5-day self-love challenge. A few of them, but one of them in particularly. She was referred to me by another TikToker who is a really good friend of mine. She was referred and she sent him an email. It was the third day of the 5-day self-love challenge. It was the third day. And she told him that she thanked him because what I've taught up to that third day saved her life. And that's not the first time I've heard that. It's not the first time. I have spoken in schools to young folk. I've experienced what I teach in my own life. I would never tell you how a strawberry tastes unless I tasted it myself. So everything that I'm telling you, not only did I learn and have been in practice, it is indisputable facts and truths that I tell you what works. No one can deny it in their right mind who knows of what I speak. Not no one on this planet. So I won't wait. Hi, Linda. Hi, Goddess. I know if you actually did the work, do the work. If you apply what I teach, I'm telling you, it will change the trajectory of your life and the lives of your loved ones. I'm wonderful. How are you today, Linda? I'm going to be getting off here shortly. This is why I say it works if you work it. And so the work that I do reminds you who you are, what you're capable of, and the necessary tools and resources it takes and how to actually apply it so you can get the results that you need. What I teach gets you into energetic alignment so you can attract everything that you want, need, and desire. So you can attract your divine masculine or your divine feminine and live the life that you were also created to live and live it in abundance with that special person in your life. Realize that there's levels within levels. And that's what I wish. That's my creed. That's my command. However, I don't force, I flow. I'm not forcing nobody's healing. I don't force. You will never find me in your inbox trying to offer you something. Trying to read you, trying to give you. You will never find me. And you might get an email from me if you're on my email list. You get first priority if you're on my VIP email list. But you will never find me in your inbox or chasing you so I can bless you. That ain't gonna work. Will you be on this weekend or the classes will resume after the holidays? I go live at least 3 times a week. But most of my in-depth teachings are through my classes that I offer. Like the 5-day self-love challenge. That is a highly requested mini course, mini master course that I teach, the Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy. I'm going to be spending most of my time there for the coming new cycle, new sun cycle. But I often come here at least 3 times a week and I teach. And if you are, I'm not sure if you heard me, you can catch all of my previous teachings if you click the link in my bio and subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's free. I repost all of my lives here. So you can go back and review those if you want to. You can also join the 5-day mini master course, 5-day self-love challenge. A lot of what I'm teaching now, I go into depth. It's more structured, it's more intimate, and it's done via Zoom, not here. Yeah, I think that is all the tips in my notes that I wanted to teach you for. So I am actually putting together a how to court date. Yes. However, how to vet wisely, right? Because many of us are getting back into the dating scene, right? And we need to know how to effectively do that, to alleviate the amount of disappointments that we can get. So you can stop choosing unwisely. Yeah, should I wait until after the holidays for the 5-day? No, you can register for the 5-day self-love challenge. It's, click the link in my bio. You can register for that. That's going to happen next month. We're going to be doing that. I do it. I'm not sure if I'll be doing it after this month. However, the next one that I'm doing is next month, January 22nd through January 27th. It's a 5-day course. So you can go register. That's available for you to enroll for that course. It's the second tab under my link tree. When you click my bio, it's the second tab. It says 5-day self-love challenge. That's the highly anticipated challenge that I give, the masterclass where I go in depth about these different things and how to get in alignment. Especially with this new year coming, this new sun cycle, you don't want to get caught doing the same things over and over again, not getting the results that you want. It doesn't make any sense. And it's time out. It's time to be responsible. It's time to be aware. It's time to be accountable for your reality. Your reality is the way it is because of you. No one else. No one else is responsible for your joy and your happiness. No one else is responsible for the opportunities that you want. No one else is responsible outside of you. And so if you want a different reality, you have to create it. And in order to do that, you have to find someone that can help you do that, that is an expert in this area. That's not going to bullshit you. That's going to tell you exactly what you need to hear, not what you want to hear, and give you the actual proven steps on how to do it. Yes, these retrogrades, listen, awareness and information is powerful, right? And if you're the type of man or woman that don't think you're deserving of a profound love, that don't think you're worthy of such a love, that don't think you're worthy of having wealth, that don't think you're worthy and deserve to do whatever you want to do, when you want to do it, without having to rob Peter to pay Paul, and vice versa, without having to worry about bills, because there are people living their absolute best life every single day in wholesome relationships. There are women being loved on in the most profound ways. There are men being loved on in the most profound ways. And there are still millions of men and women who are available. Don't listen to the bullish that people are spewing. There are beautiful, ready and available, healthy, wholesome men and women on this planet. And you don't have to chase them. You don't have to navigate. You don't have to go to a different country. If you knew who you are and just and knew how to get into energetic alignment, they will come to you. When you are energetic alignment and know who you are, you will never have to force or chase anything. It comes to you. Y'all come to it. You don't have to do much of anything. Hi, sunshine. Hi, beautiful. Mwah. Hi, lovely. You don't have to chase when you're in alignment. The only difference from those men and women living their absolute best lives, everybody that you see living their best life, hopping on jets, private planes, and islands, and drinking Bahama breezes and whatever it is, and loving on their man and show, everybody ain't capping. Everybody ain't fronting. I do realize that some of them are fronting, but a lot of them, that's their actual life. Some of us know people like that, like that's their actual life. There's no difference from them and you. The only difference from them and you is their mindset. Is that at one point they were aware that they needed to get the necessary help and information on how to get into energetic alignment to create the reality that they actually want. That's the only difference. They choose to invest in themselves, and those who are not living that life are willingly choosing not to invest in themselves. That's the only difference, honey. That's the only difference. And even though what I teach is priceless, like I don't put a value on my worth. I put a small value on my expertise. People only pay what they pay attention to. Mwah. Thank you so much for the gift, love. I appreciate your support. People pay attention to what they pay for. That's the psyche. However, I give free, invaluable information every time I go live because I'm truly passionate about what I do. The stuff that I'm teaching you, people pay me for. I mean, I'm not going into depth about things, but it is enough information to get your mind rolling to be like, you know what? Yeah. Because I'm sure this is not the first time you heard it, only I'm not that coach that's charging thousands of dollars, but I could be. And I have had in the past. I'm just choosing not to do that at the moment. Because yesterday's prices ain't going to never be today's prices, baby. And tomorrow's prices ain't going to never be today's prices. Let's be clear. Because I'm extremely confident that what I teach will absolutely change the trajectory and dynamics of your life. I'm absolutely certain if you actually apply it. Absolutely certain. So, I don't believe in coincidences. You are here because you were divinely purposed to be here. Because whatever you call God or perceive God to be, the universe has brought you here to nudge you into saying it's time. And if you were connected to me as well as I'm being connected to you, there is a divine purpose, and only a fool would miss it. Only a fool would miss it, with all due respect, because I don't believe in coincidences or happenstance. You are here and hearing what I'm saying because the universe said it's time. Because somewhere at some point, this was your intention, your mental intention, that something in my life need to change. Here's the opportunity. What are you going to do with it? What are you going to do with it? Catch me while I'm generous. Catch me while I'm generous. Cause I tell you, I am led by the spirit. So if I'm led to lower my prices for a season, I'll lower it. But the minute I get clearance to raise them back, baby, they get raised back because I am extremely confident in what I teach. I know it works. So I'm also led and I'm obedient to that because I know the consequences for me not being obedient. I don't want to pay. Yes, just having a good time. Dating only for fun, if you know what I mean. Oh, I ain't no such thing as dating for fun, honey. They know Suzette, my love. I'm familiar with you from the other day. Dating for fun, it never works out that way. If you're completely honest with yourself, this concept of dating for fun is foolish. My perspective, according to what I know, The concept of dating for fun. Oh, I'm just out here dating for fun. A wise person don't date for fun. An intentional person don't date for fun. A person that's aware don't date for fun. Understand what I'm saying. With all due respect, the only men and women who are out here dating for fun are men and women who are unlearned, unwise, unintelligent, and have no idea of the dangers that comes with this dating for fun. Now, you can have fun while dating. That's different. Now, if you meant that, by all means, you can have fun dating. But dating for fun, like it's a sport. Come on, honey. I know I should. I hope you didn't mean that. That's what I hope you didn't mean, honey. Because dating for fun get people hurt. Because while you being entertained, thinking it's a joke, somebody's investing thinking you serious, but you playing. Oh, not you. Okay. Well, I'm just going to use that as an example. So I appreciate you and my apologies if that's what you didn't mean. However, that's still a really good teaching point because there are people who say that, love. There are people who say they just out here dating for fun. That's dangerous. Those are dangerous people. Y'all stay clear away from people talking about, oh, I'm just having fun, baby. On the other side of the planet, you go do fun because, baby, listen, every beautiful breath that I'm able to take, every ounce of energy that I have, it is not a joke. Although I can laugh about life because it's beautiful, but don't get it twisted. Nothing about my choices is a joke. Nothing. And it shouldn't be a joke for you too. It shouldn't be a joke to you. They get mad at me for saying stop playing with people. Yes. Listen, Linda. Listen. Stop getting, if you are one person who's entertaining that concept, or know someone entertaining that concept, baby, please let them know it can be absolutely dangerous. There are people out here taking other people's lives because they're dating for fun. They're dating thinking it's a joke. They're playing with people. And people out here transitioning prematurely, putting themselves in situation, playing with people's emotions and their feelings and their life like that. You can have fun while dating, but dating... I'm just out here. That can be dangerous. Like, you don't love your life. You don't love your life. You might as well go ahead and export yourself off this realm. If that's how you really feel. It is dangerous playing with people's lives like that. I stay clear. Oh, first of all, I don't even attract those people. But I hear people saying these things. I'm just dating for fun. Dating for fun? Negro, ma'am, sir, dating for fun. Kids go to the playground just for fun. You ain't no damn child. Like, grow up. You are not no damn child. People go to amusement parks for fun. People go to concerts for fun. People go to comedy shows for fun. People play in a playground for fun. They go to different type of events for fun. They don't play with people for fun. And that's not being directed towards you, love. I'm just speaking because that is people's mindset. I've heard them. It's serious for some people. The most important thing is their time. It's serious. Even though I've never had that concept and that mindset. I didn't play with people like that. Like it was just fun. You know what I'm saying? I've always loved. I always wanted, you know, at that time, like I wanted, you know, Prince Charming to come in my life and sweep me up off my feet. And, you know, I wanted to, you know, the house, the kids and all of this stuff that I didn't know nothing about. Right. However, it can be. Thank you. Hi, sweetheart. Hi, Jade. Hi, my love. Hi, honey. That's my baby. Listen, We have to stop doing that and realize how dangerous it can be. It's crucial out here. We got to stop thinking that even the people who subscribe to, oh, I'm just out here, you know, having sex for fun. Let me tell you something. You better realize how powerful your yoni is, how powerful your phallus is. Because you're going to F around one day and give it to the wrong person, and they'll try to take you out. I personally experienced it. A man being so obsessed with my power and my energy. I personally experienced it. Not that I needed that experience to take myself more seriously and to know in my power and the power of my sensual and sexual essence, but that was an extremely profound experience, learning experience for me. And I didn't even know all that I know now. And this was a steady boyfriend in my time, but because I was in my ignorance, chose unwisely, I ignored all the psychopathic clues that this man was showing me. This man was psychotic, crazy. Like the Looney Bin and Looney Tune AF-ish on him. Nothing. Hey, Finity, how are you, love? We have to be mindful. We have to be careful. This is why dating, getting the necessary information and tools and learning what you need prior to that. Thank you. This is why learning what you need to learn, discipline, maturity, awareness, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, physically, and financially, because your life should not be nothing you should keep playing with. It should be nothing you keep playing with. Sometimes it's dangerous in these streets. People are experiencing their last straw. And you never know. And because you're in your unlearned mind, you're like, oh, I'm just going to do this. Or I'm just going to do that. And I'm just going to, you know, dabble over here and dabble over that. And for some people, that's their last goddamn dabble. Oh, y'all don't see the stories? Y'all don't watch? I mean, I don't watch it no more, but I hear of it. What is that called? First 48? And all these people having these psychotic breaks and killing their wives and girlfriends and husbands and all of these. Come on now. Like, when are you going to stop playing around with your life? So I'm here to remind some of you, stop playing with your life, literally. You deserve so much more and so much greater. Stop being desperate. Do what you need to do to elevate. So you can start choosing better. So you not only choosing better, so you can attract better. Right? Some of us don't even ask ourselves important and valuable questions before we even just jump ourselves right into the dating scene. Some of us don't even know who we are. We don't remember who we are, let alone know what we want. And so you keep on getting in these situationships, not knowing what you want. And as soon as you get a clue, now you arguing, you bickering, you beefing, and it's toxic. Hi, how you doing, love? Right? And so, Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy is also, I'm also going to be teaching on how to be in alignment, how to prepare yourself to even start dating. Because there's way too many single women in the world, way too many single men in the world. And this is not a part of what we're designed to also do in this realm. And I'm all about solutions. I want to fix that. So I know that when women start rising, when women start being accountable and taking responsibility and getting the help and assistance they need and start applying it just as well as the men, boy, there will be so much love vibrating in this world, right? There will be so much more black love. There will be so much more healthy relationships, wholesome relationships, community, right? And so this is what Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy, even though it's exclusively for women, the more of us get into alignment and in position, the more we can teach and guide and influence from a healthy and a wholesome, from a patient, from a compassionate, empathetic place. Instead of us keep breeding misery and dysfunction and hurt and bitterness. There are plenty of sisters who are out here who don't know what we need to know, but want to know and make and taking active steps in figuring it out. Rise of a Goddess Academy was created for us. I've created it specifically, exclusively for women, for the divine feminine, because I know when more of us get into alignment and take our place and stop and learn to let go of everything that happened, stop being trauma bound, really heal to a degree where we can learn to truly love not only ourselves, but one another. We will not only change the trajectory of our lives, but we will change the trajectory of the world. Do y'all know that? But we're so busy holding on to our past traumas, our past experiences, to all the hurt and the pain day after day after day after day. And it becomes year after year after year. And who is it helping and serving? Who? No one. King's Caliber, how you doing, love? Ashe, I appreciate you. Who is it? Come on now. We got to stop this. We got to stop pointing the finger. We have got to stop hurting one another. At this point, the reasons don't matter. At this point, at this crucial point where we are, not only within our individual lives, but our collective lives as a whole. At this point, what's done is done. What happened doesn't matter. You know what is important and what matters? What we choose to do now. What we choose to do now matters. It's the only thing that matters, because it's the only thing that's going to shape and continually shape the future. Will you be a part? Will you be a part of the solution, or will you continually be a part of the problem, of the issues? Will you finally make the decision that you deserve greater? Will you finally make the decision that it is also y'all to do something about what's going on, the dynamics of the world? Something has to give. Something has to give. We cannot keep this shit up. We can't, and far too many of us are entertaining foolish men and women, condoning their foolish ass behaviors in these stupid conversations, these unhealthy, dumb, foolish conversations, toxic ass conversations about why women should go 50-50 or why men should go in this concept and who brings what to the table and who's accountable and who's not accountable and who broke my heart 10 years ago, who stole my bike 5 years ago, who didn't love me 10 years ago, what he or she did to me. I like this song. Y'all good? I like this song. Come on, let's vibe a little bit before we end the live. Until next time. Hi, beautiful. Hi, lady. Hi, honey. Hi. Made it this far for better. Hey, look at get them yellow hearts. I got you. I'm going to play that next. I got you. Listen, I love that song. Hold on. I'm getting ready to play our Until Next Time song. Mwah! Thank you so much for the gifts. For those of you who are not used to me yet, we vibe when we come in these lives. On this side of the TikTok, we are all about self-mastery. We're all about elevating. We're all about divine love, learning, and growing together. So we vibe when we enter, and we vibe until next time. And for those who know, I see them yellow hearts. Okay, this is our Until Next Time. I don't say bye. We don't say bye because we are never apart, just like Celie and her sisters, honey. We are never apart. So until next time, I love you. Infinite blessings, enlightenment, divine love, peace, abundance, prosperity. Do not forget to, if you haven't registered for the next 5-day self-love challenge, if you are a divine feminine, do not forget to enroll in Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy. We're about to get started and it is launching soon, honey. Okay? Hear what you're hearing. Hey, let me see them yellow hearts. Tap the screen. Thank you for the gifts. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Y'all already know y'all golden. Y'all already know y'all dripping with gold, baby.
I'm taking my freedom.
I love you too, Rasheed. Come on. Come on. Let's see them yellow hearts. Come on. Come on.
Taking my freedom. Putting it in my car. Wherever I choose to go, it won't take me far.
Hey, come on, come on, come on.
Moving all day long, I'm taking my freedom, putting it in my soul. I'll be hot stepping, y'all, letting the joy unfold.
Comes naturally, honey.
And
me representing your glory. Hey, come on now. Come on now. Hi, baby. Hi, honey. Blackberry molasses. Peace, baby. Golden, living my life like it's golden, living my life like it's golden, living your life like it's golden, live your life like it's golden, baby. Y'all, you hear me?
Golden, golden, golden,
Listen, I love y'all. I love y'all. Remember, if no one else told you or you haven't heard it in a long time, I sincerely love you, appreciate you, and I really do want the very best for you. I really don't. Because when you rise, I rise. When you're happy, I'm happy. We are one. We are one. You deserve love. You deserve the abundance. You deserve it all. You deserve a profound sisterhood. You deserve it. I love you guys. And I always look forward to seeing all of the faces, the familiar faces, the familiar names. Realize that you all give me just as much as inspiration and encouragement as I give you. And I am so full of gratitude for it. I truly am. Thank you. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for sharing your energy with me. Thank you for the gifts you give me. Thank you for spending your time with me. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being a part of the solution and not the issue. Thank you for sharing people with me. Thank you for speaking of me. I'm just full of gratitude for each and every one of you. And you are always included. All of you guys, even though I don't know some of you by name, some of you I do because we're still connecting. We're a family and we're getting familiar with each other. However, my decree and my manifestation and my meditation is always that the universe bless you and continually chase you with abundance, and that you continually choose you and remember who you are and remember that you are so much worth every beautiful thing that this planet has to offer in you. So until next time, I look forward to seeing you guys in Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy soon. Before we go, for those of you who are already enrolled in Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy, please do check the private Facebook group. There is a message that I put in there for you so you can answer it. Mwah. Thank you. Thank you, love. I appreciate you. I appreciate you so much, love. Thank you. Let me follow you because I appreciate you supporting me the way you did throughout this live. Oh, goodness. Oh, I feel loved. Yes, baby. Press down, shaking together, and running over. Ain't that what they say? I love it. Thank you guys so much. For all of the Divine Goddesses who is in the Rise of a Goddess VIP Academy, please make sure you check the private Facebook group. I do leave messages in there for you guys so you can put your input, different things like that. So I love you. And until next time, I look forward to seeing you guys' enrollment in the Academy and those of you who was here that you registered for the 5-Day Self-Love Challenge so you can be on your purpose, okay? It doesn't make sense to hear and not do. Love you.